Hello, I think that's time. My name is Sveta Smirnova, and you see on this slide another name. Alexander Rubin is principal architect at Percona, and actually he was the person who made most of work on these slides. He ran tests, he measured this time and his results. Unfortunately, he could not come. So this is why only me is here. Okay, so what will we talk about today? Will we talk about Apache Spark, why and how to use it? I will focus on how to use it together with MySQL. And for examples, we use wiki states analysis. This is a free database available for download. It's about 10 terabyte. So what is Spark? If compared to MySQL, you see this picture. It's like for MySQL timers, my probably a full picture. You see how MySQL works. So first, your application sends a request. And then MySQL has to parse it, has to validate it, has to optimize it, sends it to storage engine. If it needs to save results, it has to write it up to file system and return results and process. It does everything. So this big work. Spark, in contrast, does only computing. And only computing. It's sends to third party like Amazon S3, local file systems, and MySQL, and actually many, it supports many backends. It's just only computers, but does it in parallel. And this is why you need it. So why you need it? You need it, its most use case is processing big data in a single query, which for MySQL this is not the best thing to do, and I will describe here later why. What is about Spark? It's there are like old files like FAQ, you have. You have to have enough memory for full dataset. This is not true. Spark processes data in memory, but it's mostly like MySQL with caches. It also has direct access to data sources, including MySQL, and can be any. Can store data in distributed file system. It's Hadoop, HDFS, and a local file system. Places it has native Python and R integration, but this is massively parallel. This is most important thing about Spark. It can compute in multiple threads, and also it can compute distribute on multiple nodes. So you can scale on a single machine on multiple cores, and you can also scale on multiple machines. So this is increasing parallel. So let's compare Spark with MySQL. Imagine you need to process a big query with MySQL. So what you will need, you will have indexes. You will like to have indexes. You will also have partitioning. And what is for single query, MySQL will just read data from one partition if you created it properly, wisely. There is also possible sharding, which is not built in, but you can implement sharding with MySQL. Spark, in its case, it doesn't have indexes, and I will describe later why. It has partitioning, but partitioning not in MySQL case, but you can process, you can partition your data, and you can perform calculation on every partition in parallel. It also, instead of sharding, it has a kind of MapReduce architecture, so it sends processing requests on different nodes. So why no indexes? So what is the biggest issue with MySQL? So it's one query, it's one core. So it can MySQL you can use multiple cores if you have many queries. But it cannot use multiple cores if you have only one query, if you have terabytes of petabytes of data for this table, you just and you have it's only one query, you will use one CPU core no matter how much your machine has. For Spark, it has no indexes. It's just practically a full table scan, but its full table scan scans only part of tables in multiple threads and in a parallel. So it's if you have one machine with multiple cores, you can have data that's split on parts and scan them in parallel by every core. If you have multiple nodes, you can have multiple nodes. You can split data by differently on them, and again perform this calculation on these nodes. And again, each node can have calculation in parallel. This leads to high latency because after this result set is processed, you have to combine it into single result. So it will take latency depends from for any MySQL cluster, it's like nodes have to communicate. So why is Spark doesn't use indexes? Well, how many of you work with indexes in MySQL? So I think you can imagine what happens if you create the index for petabyte of data, or if you update index, or if you read a terabyte index. not fast. Full scan in parallel could be much easier. Okay, so ETL pipeline. So what is extract, transform, load. So in MySQL, it works like you can extract data from source, transform it before loading. Before loading, because it must be valid and must be in format which MySQL understand, and only then insert into MySQL. So you will spend a lot of time here. No, it's also here because you will load petabytes of data, and only after that you can actually process your data. For Spark, you can you are extracting data, you don't save anything, but then you can just load, you don't transform it. So this is you load data as you get it. So you don't need to spend time here. But then you can, after returning results to clients, you can transform, analyze, visualize, and do it everything in parallel here. So that's called difference. Like MySQL is scheme of write. This means when you load data, it has validated. It has performed conversion, sometimes indirect. And also it will fail if something wrong with your data. And also if it's like science, it's modern MySQL storage engines are in a DBR transactional, and it will have rollback this transaction, so it will spend time. So if you have loaded only partial of data, it's maybe nightmare. For Spark, it's scheme on read, so there is no load data per se, so it can just rsync to nodes or rsync to data or just read it. And when it's validate data on read, it's transform data on read, and even if it's something goes wrong on the step, it's much cheaper to reject. So you just reject, you don't have to discard anything. Example. For our example, we took Wiki States database, which is available from this URL. It has Wikipedia page access counts. It's file is greater than 10 terabytes. And here is how it can be downloaded into MySQL. So it's load data in file, insert into table, fields terminated by. It also has a transformation, so that slow down things a little bit too. And how much will it take? It will take for an ADB, will take 50 seconds, for MySAM 11 seconds. So 1 hour it will take 1 minute, and 1 year will take 6 days, and 6 years will take greater than 1 month to load. Loading Wiki state into Spark will be much more easy. It's just copy files to any storage you like, and then create SQL structure over it. or create read the CVS or aggregate it and transform it and load it, for example, in MySQL, but process in parallel. So you have like not all 10 terabytes, but only data you need for this. Here is an example. It's not our example. It's example at Spark Summit about loading data into Spark. It's without MySQL involvement. It took 45 seconds for scanning the 4.5 terabytes of data. Impressive. Why? Because pipelines. It's better to compare with pipelines. Well, MySQL, it's one pipeline, and Spark, it's like multiple. So much bigger throughput, it's much more job can be done at the same time. So how Spark works? Here on the left in the green boxes, it's how we will process MySQL MySQL query, MySQL build query. First, we run select. And for Spark, it will just like lines read file. So nothing much here. Then we run where. Spark, this will be mapping them, which lines we are going to read. Then for group by, it's practically data processing, and out file we will write to either like in first row is to MySQL, and second row is we can write like, for example, to parquet file. This is columnar storage. And actually there are many backends which we can save data to. Here is example of how to save results to MySQL. This is, I think, pretty easy. And here, what happens after you run this code? So it's show process list output. So I think it explains a lot. Spark split all the data into multiple requests, and they are massively parallel. So we are now here with Spark. MySQL can use, can explore its own ways and explore multiple CPU cores. And here is the confirmation. So multiple CPU cores, and that's, I think it's with pretty easy code. Besides expressing, there is PSpark shell, which allows you to monitor Spark job. It has nice graphical user interface, so you can see what is going on. And practically, you can find out what happens with particular job. This job file it with, because table was full, but you can read it's what happens here. Okay, so we put all data we read all wiki states, and now let's try to use Spark for reads and for data analysis. For this comparing, what we want to know, that's we want to find 10 most queried wiki pages in January 2008, and for MySQL it took to retrieve only these 10 rows took 1 hour 22 minutes, and with Spark it took less time. It's 20 minutes. Impressive. Okay, so what else? We have like this talk, it's about Apache Drill. You can also use Apache Drill. This Apache Drill is a little bit competing solution, but also can use together. It allows to access data sources differently and treat them as SQL. It can query MongoDB with SQL, and it can query both MySQL and MongoDB combine results together. So that's another great tool for data analysis. Magic? Quite not easy. It's just to recap, MySQL and Spark are MySQL and Spark are difference, and what is the difference? So what's you know, these two 5 points. So MySQL, it's searches full data set which must which may be pre-filtered and not aggregated. But for Spark, data set is already. That means that it's just can read any data set for prepared from application, from file. It can be filtered like only on site, like in case if you shard data on geographically and so on. MySQL doesn't support parallelism if you run a single query. Spark supports parallelism, and it also supports parallelism on all levels, from having from multiple cores on single machine and to multiple nodes. MySQL is based on index. Spark is not based on index, but having its does everything in parallel. This doesn't it is not bad. It's work good for big data. For in a DB, if like if you, I think we have it's for in a for MySQL, it doesn't have, no, it's actually it has column storage. I think it's MariaDB, but even in any case, it has to has to convert data into column storage, for example. So this is in the between this. And in Spark, if you want columnar storage, you can get it just like specifying like work if you want to work like in solution like Parquet, but not with MySQL. Partitioning for MySQL, it's for single query. That means, no, it's actually for anyway. It means like partition used only to select select data which is to access, and if you like need to process data from two partitions, you cannot, you will process data from one partition and then from another. For Spark partitioning, you will process data from both partitions and at the same time and then combine results. So in my opinion, that's you can, if you need to work with big data, if you need to make big analysis, combining this together can get best results. It's a luxury of SQL. It's easy to use SQL. It's which we prefer to use, and massively parallelism, which makes it really that such queries really efficient. Thank you. It's actually, you can use no, almost same dialect like MySQL. It's not like MySQL, it's not like exactly MySQL dialect, but
thank you, Sveta. Thank you, Alex, if he sees us on the streaming.